So just a word about the Children's Liver Foundation. I would like to show you a short film to just let you know what Children's Liver Foundation has been doing. This is our 9th meeting. Children's Liver Foundation was set up in 2011. And I would take this opportunity to actually thank our experts, our national faculty, who year on year have been coming very enthusiastically and participating in our meetings and really giving them the edge, which all of you appreciate. So we have Dr. Bavdekar here. Dr. Bavdekar just from KM Pune. Dr. Malati Satyasekaran from Chennai. Dr. Anshu Srivastav from SGPGI Lucknow. Dr. Yacha. He is the father of gastroenterology, pediatric gastroenterology, ex-head Sanjay Gandhi, and now the head at Sakra Hospital in Bangalore. And we have Dr. John Mathai, you know him. He's conducted an excellent quiz. Dr. Amdekar, you all know Dr. Amdekar. We all love him for his teaching and passion. And we have the two IAP president and ex-president with us. So without any further delay, I would like to just show you what CLF has been doing through a short film.
राम ऐसा नहीं करता था, एक ही जगह बैठा रहता था, रोता रहता था, ज्यादा पीला ज्यादा लगने लगता था, उसका पेट बड़ा हो जाता था, वो रो रहा था, वो जो खाना खाता था वो सब वॉमिटिंग कर देता था।
वो मतलब बहुत ही बुरे दिन थे हमारे।
मुझे नहीं पता था एक CLF साइट मुझे राम की जिंदगी बचाने का मौका देगा।
When I came back from my stint abroad to train in liver disorders, we had a lot of children being referred with liver disorders. What I realized as an adult liver specialist was that there was hardly any awareness about liver diseases in children, especially amongst the medical profession. And obviously that got extrapolated to the general population. It was a completely different spectrum. Their diseases were much more complex. They had many genetic disorders and the diagnosis of which was not easy. So the first thing we did was starting case discussions for groups of pediatricians on liver diseases. So we realized that the need was much bigger and we needed to do it in a more formalized manner.
CLF has also hosted the annual meeting for ISPIGIN in October 2018. We also hold support group meetings at the foundation for various rare diseases like Wilson's disease, Budd-Chiari, Gaucher disease, and patients with thalassemia suffering with hepatitis C.
It was important that the children also, and their parents more importantly, kind of knew more of what their child was suffering from.
डॉक्टर ने डायग्नोसिस किया ये बहुत डिफिकल्ट बीमारी है केतकी के इंजेक्शन की कॉस्टिंग करीबन 11 लाख हर महीना है जैसे अभी हम एड मिल रही है एक बंद कमरा रहता है तो उसमें हमें रोशनी ढूंढ रहे थे तो जैसे आभा मैडम थी वो हमारे लिए रोशनी थी
वी स्टार्टेड हेल्पिंग फैमिलीज फाइनेंशियली आल्सो started collaborating with various organizations. We collaborated with Think Foundation.
What I like most about Children's Liver Foundation is that they don't make you feel that they have done a gratitude kind of thing for you. I'm so thrilled that I'm a partner with Children's Liver Foundation. I have had interactions with them which have been very, very satisfying. In thalassemia, they are dependent on blood transfusions all the time. They are at risk for HIV, hepatitis B, hepatitis C. It's a double attack on the liver. Children's Liver Foundation has been godsend, really. It changed everything. Today, people are confident of saying, yes, I know that I can come out of it.
I've been on transfusion since then. A decade back, I got to know that I'm diagnosed with hepatitis C. So we just had an injection. The cost was around 1 lakh per month. I had to take that injection for 9 months. So just imagine the cost.
we started this whole process of advocacy. There were these new drugs which were available in the Western market, and they were horribly expensive. One pill costed $1,000. We also filed an RTI with the government. The entire treatment for 6 months was $300 when the companies in India started manufacturing these drugs. We had a similar advocacy for patients with Wilson's disease.
We are also coming forward with a lot of donation drives, including the conferences, seminars, and then trying to reach out to the maximum well-wishers, those who can support us.
CLF has been very supportive by holding seminars and picnics. It helped us be involved with the latest findings, updates, medical research.
The challenges I faced with this Wilson disease was I had medicines to kill myself. After I realized that this is nothing, just keep smiling, live your life.
The number of phone calls I received, the number of emails seeking help, patients struggling with funds, they feel so helpless. Really like if we have more helping hands.
One big challenge for us is to really help children long term. After the transplant, they require drugs, they require regular blood tests, they may need hospitalization, and really there is no help at that time. That's where I would see Children's River Foundation coming in and helping these children beyond the transplant.
Adopt a liver.
With this, I would now like Dr. Mathai, president of ISPGAN, to say a few words.
Thank you, Abha. I think it's the 8th or 9th year, and I think I've been coming here every year. And I want to congratulate Abha on this effort. And I think the participation from all of you, I have seen over the years, has been increasing. And I think we've also tried to introduce something new every year. And this year was that quiz. And the whole idea is to popularize the concept that liver diseases in children are not uncommon, number one. And number two, that in many situations, something can be done. Often people think nothing can be done. And I think what has been achieved over these years has been to create that awareness about liver diseases, which I think has been very successfully done by Dr. Abha and her team. And I want to congratulate them on behalf of the Indian Society of Pediatric Gastroenterology. Thank you, Abha.
Thank you, Dr. Mathai. Dr. Amdekar.
I think I'm neither the office bearers of any organization. I think the culture demands that seniority and senility should be respected. That's why possibly Abha wants me to be here. I'm so happy that these small focal conferences teach a lot of us, rather than the big melas that occur in most of the other associations. And I feel that when general pediatricians meet the specialists, both the parties are at benefit, because there are multiple problems that do not start with liver but end with liver, and most of us wouldn't see them much often than you all. At the same time, we learn something beyond a usual hepatology or GI. I thank you very much, and I think I wish all this today's meeting a great success. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Amrita. Dr. Vinay Joshi, please.
Yeah, good morning. And what Dr. Amdekar sir said, I think totally agree with that. The short, small CMEs and the workshops, they help us a lot to learn more and educate us more. I saw the program, it's fantastic. In the first hour itself, I learned myself a lot. And definitely during the day, we all will learn much more. Thank you very much. Thanks for the invitation.
Dr. Udaypai.
Thank you, Dr. Abad, for this opportunity. And I think, you know, we started a decade back, and IIP Mumbai got closely associated with it. And I think year after year, more and more students are looking forward to this program almost a year ahead. And I think this is spreading across the country. And the most important thing is, yes, you know, like Dr. Amdekar said, capacity building. You know, it's generating interest in the newer generation to now focus themselves on particular areas of medicine and pediatric gastroenterology, which was years back, where Dr. Yacha was the father of pediatric gastroenterology, now is becoming an actual, you know, necessity, and a lot of students are looking forward to it. Thank you, Abhat, and all the best in future also.
Thank you all. We end the inauguration here. We always have very informal, unconventional inaugurations, as Dr. Amdekar and Dr. Mathai know for years.